Just stay at court as long as you need to. Little Victor and I are here as snug as a bug in a rug. All right. Bye-bye. That was Taya, your pretend mommy. Like I'm your pretend Susan, but not for long. Pretty soon I'm going back to being Heather. And then you're going to get to call me mommy. Yes, you are, sweetie. And guess what? This time, I'm going to do motherhood right.
Spinelli, did you find something?
I've been researching babies born in Port Charles the night of the storm, and I regret to inform that I have no idea from whence or from whom Heather procured the child that we believe she switched with Sam's.
I know where Heather got the baby.
You found the baby?
What baby?
Spinelli.
Hey, you there?
Apologies. I will keep in touch. Thanks.
Hi.
Hey, I didn't hear you come in. Did you pick the lock?
No, I still have a key. Oh. What's all this?
Oh,
Special bombs. The baby. They have a baby?
No, they don't. Just another case.
So we have a new client?
No. Oh, I mean, I do. I mean, it's not really a client. It's more of a friend, you know. Not official. Just long-lost relative stuff. No, nothing you need to worry about.
Really? Nothing I can do to help?
No, I got it. I'm just happy to see you here. Dare I hope that you're here for a reconciliation or at least to talk to your husband?
Actually, I came to, drop off these to Jason.
Divorce papers?
Hey. I pulled Taya Delgado's file. The baby has Tenpo blood. So he can be Sam's son.
It's not an uncommon blood type. In and of itself, doesn't prove anything.
Was there anything else in the records? Anything that looked out of the ordinary?
Baby showed signs of an iron deficiency, and I told Ms. Delgado that he could be at risk for beta thalassemia, which is a blood disorder commonly found in people of Mediterranean.
Right, I know what that is, because it was in Sam's baby's file because of the Cassidine family.
It's not a rare disorder.
Delgado. That sounds Hispanic.
Puerto Rican.
Is Ms. Delgado a carrier of hemophilia? Do you know?
Why?
Because the baby that isn't Sam's had hemophilia, had undeveloped lungs, and had a blood type that's not compatible with Sam's. But this baby, Miss Delgado's baby, had Sam's blood type and a genetic condition that goes along with Sam's family.
I know where you're going
with. It all adds up. Sam's baby's alive.
You and Jason have reached the point of irreconcilable differences?
My mother drew up the papers, was thinking Diane should probably look them over and then Jason could sign them.
Well, I can't help but notice that you delivered the papers in person, which does indeed indicate a desire to see your husband while he's still
your Spinelli,
husband.
No, it indicates that I was in the neighborhood and it was easier for me to drop the papers off here than have my mother send over a messenger.
That's plausible, but I cry foul on your explanation. I think you're lying. I mean, if not to me, at least to yourself. You came here hoping for a chance meeting that would lead to a reconciliation.
What are you
doing? Well, I'm calling your husband.
No, you are not, Spinelli. That is not fair. You can't put him on the spot like that.
So you still care about his feelings?
Spinelli,
you still love
stop
him.
It. Please. I know you care about both of us, but Jason and I agreed that we can't hurt each other anymore, so we're going to move on.
But you're Sam and Jason. You overcome all odds. You're the dragon and the phoenix. If you two can't make it, what hope is there for the rest of us?
You're meeting Jason here. Why?
I don't know. Morgan said it happened.
May I ask how things stand between you and Sam?
They stand nowhere. She's going through a divorce.
Well, relationships are complex at the best of times. And they can fall apart for all kinds of reasons. That being said, you did put yourself in the middle of a marriage and you paid attention to the wife. And arguably, you're the wedge that drove them apart.
That's true. That wasn't very nice of me, was it?
Yeah, I'm not standing in judgment. Good Lord, I have messed up pretty much every relationship I've ever been in. All I'm pointing out is that you made a dangerous man angry. And I know that you're totally capable of dangerous in your own right. But Jason, he's considered lethal for a reason.
We're gonna play nice, I promise. Besides, you have to find Heather Weber.
Hey, Jason. I don't have to remind you of our conversation you had the first day that I was police commissioner about you respecting the law and me taking you down if you don't.
How could I forget?
Good.
Any news on Heather?
No, not yet. Why? Did you have a run-in with her?
No, not me, Sam.
Well, we all want her captured and put away where she can't do any more damage, don't we? I'll let you know if there's any news. My real name? Come on. Heather Weber! You got it! Good boy! And your real mommy is Samantha Morgan. But, well, she thinks you're dead. Wrong. And she thinks Franco's your daddy. Wrong again. See, Jason Morgan's your real daddy, but he'll never know. Because I switched the results of the DNA test. But don't worry. You're better off. They just didn't deserve you. I mean, Jason and Sam, his parents. No. Who wants that? Besides, you'll be better off with me. Because, you see, I need a do-over. You're going to be my brand new Stephen Lars. And I'm going to be the best mommy in the whole wide world.
What are we doing here?
It's about Sam.
Let's hear it.
I think Sam's little boy is alive and living in Landview. Records indicate that the baby's blood type was AB negative. Sam and Frank are both O positive. They couldn't be that baby's parents.
Is it possible the ME entered the wrong blood type on the form?
No, Sam donated the baby's tissue. It was still in the lab. The AB negative is confirmed. So the child who died that night is not Sam's. Couldn't have been.
Okay, what else you got?
Lungs weren't developed. Autopsy report said he couldn't have lived even if he was on a ventilator, and the baby that you delivered that night in the motel was strong and was crying
breathing
out.
Perfectly. Yeah,
breathing perfectly.
It always bothered me that he got so sick so fast.
Sam was always regular with her prenatal screenings. Everything showed that baby was perfectly healthy, no indications of a lung problem or hemophilia. The baby that died that night had both. And then you throw in the fact that the blood type does not match, it couldn't have been that child.
So how did they get switched?
Well, we know Sam left the motel. She wandered out into the woods. She found the garden shed. She put the baby down. She went inside looking for help, and she passed out. Now, as close as I can figure it, she was unconscious anywhere between 15 and 45 minutes.
45 minutes, that's your window of opportunity that someone could have taken her son.
Heather had access to that shack. That's where she held Luke Spencer prisoner.
That was later, though. Spencer was in custody that night.
Heather wasn't. A cop pulled Heather over on Route 59 near mile marker 13. It's the road closest to that shack. She had a passenger, what turned out to be Anthony Zakhar's corpse. She buried Anthony about 100 yards from that shack.
Oh, so Heather was out there, right?
Yes.
Without another infant. I mean, you can't make your theory work.
Steve Weber treated a Miss Taya Delgado and her newborn son the night of the storm. She had her baby at a bus stop on Route 59. Not far from that shack, and when the baby was born, he wasn't breathing. The man with Miss Delgado took her son and went looking for help.
Manning. Okay.
Spinelli, you know I love you, and so does Jason. You're our best friend.
And you know I do anything for you, both as individuals and as a couple, which you are clearly meant to be.
Yes, I know, and that is the problem.
What do you mean?
Well, it's just that there's a point where your devotion to all things Sam and Jason, it becomes a little unfair.
I wasn't aware I'd caused you any grief. I'm sorry.
It's just that Jason and I are human. We make mistakes. We mess up. We fail. And I think that you put us on this pedestal and make us live up to these certain expectations, and it's just not realistic, and you're only setting yourself up for disappointment.
Should I ask less of people, and that will in turn make me happier?
No.
I'm sorry, this isn't about me and my expectations. But the truth is, you love Jason, and he loves you, and yes, you've had your share of difficulties, but you still may yet prevail. Sam, you deserve a happy ending. And it may not happen overnight, but just don't give up on Jason. Not now, not a minute before the miracle.
What do you mean? What miracle?
Love is a miracle. And it will grace you yet again. Just you gotta give it time.
I'm sorry, Spinelli. It's just that Jason and I have put this divorce off long enough.
Okay, well, then what's one more day?
Why are you pushing this so hard? What's so important about today?
Do you need to ask? It's your anniversary.
I know, and I didn't plan it this way. I just want to be able to move on and put it all behind me. The same way you moved on from Maxie. I've always wanted you and Maxie to make it, but it turns out that you weren't right for each other. And I've accepted that. And you know what, Spinelli? I'm proud of you because you were able to move on. Now Jason and I, we have to do the same thing.
But you're mistaken. Jason hasn't moved on.
I saw Jason with Elizabeth on his birthday. She threw him a private birthday party.
You're misunderstanding. Elizabeth is helping Jason.
No, I am not. They were kissing, Spinelli. And it was mutual. You know what? It's fine. It's fine because I'm getting a divorce.
No,
it's okay.
Please believe me. Jason's doing everything he can to make up for what he did.
I've already forgiven Jason for what happened with the baby. But our problems, they run deeper than that. Spinelli, you've got to accept that we're over.
Well, in point of fact, I don't. And nor do I have to watch you serve these papers to Jason. Sam, you have a right to your feelings, but you're making a mistake.
Jason and I agreed that we weren't going to hurt each other anymore.
A year ago today, you and Jason stood in the courtyard behind Noodle Buddha and exchanged vows. You swore to try to make it work till death do you part. You can at least give it one more day.
Birth. There's a problem with the baby. And she hands him off to Todd.
And Heather's in the woods around that same time burying Anthony.
Okay. So Heather, Todd, and Sam, they all converge on the shack, and the babies are switched. See, that's what I have a problem with. You know, Manning, Weber, yes. There's no way Taya's involved
well,
in this.
Maybe she didn't know about it.
Taya did say that Todd took off with the baby, and she didn't meet up with him until later when the baby started breathing on his own.
Yes, exactly. It's not our baby.
Manning. He owed Taya for killing her husband. You know, he would have done anything, including stealing someone else's baby to guarantee her a healthy child. But where does Heather Weber fit in on this?
Well, according to Taya Delgado, Manning ran into a Good Samaritan, an unidentified woman who performed CPR and got the baby breathing.
Heather Weber. Well, that explains her interaction with Manning, you know, him giving her a job at the Sun and all the legal support. Of course, we can't talk to Heather. She escaped Ferncliff.
There's just one problem. Todd Manning. He used to live here in Landview. And then he killed his brother. That's who Taya thinks is your daddy. You see, the deal is, Todd tried to call Taya last week. I managed to erase the message, but sooner or later he's going to get through. And then Taya's going to tell him about her marvelous new nanny. And then he's going to tell her that I am not actually Susan Moore, and then we're going to have a problem. So, here's what I'm thinking. While Taya's stuck in court, you and I are going to take a little trip. What do you say? Road trip?
You can't talk to Heather, but you can question Manning.
I don't want to tip him off, give him time to cover his tracks.
You know, we start chasing leads and we're wrong. A lot of people are going to get hurt.
Here's an alternative. You test the DNA of the baby that Taya took home on Landview.
Which is where I come in.
It's the only way to know for sure.
Taya loves that little boy, you know. He helped her keep going after her husband was murdered.
You can't ignore what you know now. You find the proof one way or the other. If you care about Sam, you're gonna help get her son back.
Need some change? You like our collection? Yep, it's all the stuff people leave behind and don't care enough to come back for.
Where do you want to get our new life started? Corinth? Pigeon Hollow? I hear Pine Valley's very lovely this time of year.
You're on time. Your wife just arrived.
It's time to hit the road. We better get out of here before someone catches us.